Hello and welcome to another episode of the Vipers podcast. Today we're going to be joined with our special guest Ben from the Ghost Tiger demo team, also
Hello,
known
everybody.
As the ex Viper leader.
Good evening everyone, how's everyone doing tonight?
Okay.
And good.
We're also joined by Army Now 123, also known as Dimar. We're joined by Josh.
Oh god.
The man, the myth, the legend, Bing Bong.
Bing Bong!
And just Sully.
Boston Tea Party.
No one's gonna understand that unless you're a GCSE history student. Okay, so we're gonna get right into the start of stuff, and so we're gonna ask Ben his first question. How did you first get into the flight kind of community as a whole with the because you led the white arrows, didn't you?
Well, yes. First of all, started out with the white arrows, but then also I did have a laser solo display team on side with that.
Alright.
And then everything changed from the with the laser solo team. It just went, it pretty much just went all popular, so I thought we'd just give it a name instead of calling it laser solo display team.
Because I remember we both talked about it for some time and we were like, like what could we name it?
I mean, because like especially with the white arrows. I mean, like I think that was a bit of a odd name at first, but then the thing is, I thought when we came up with LS Vipers.
Yeah, I mean, credit to Antari with that as well. We mentioned her in the very first podcast.
Yes.
So if you're watching Antari, big up.
Big up, Antari. What's that massive? No.
So yeah, basically from the very beginning, because like you're probably like one of the very very first people in the whole kind of flight community.
I think I was one that kicked off the flight community. I'm pretty sure. I can't remember if that's true.
I don't know, but be careful what you say, because someone will probably be in the comments bashing their keyboard or.
Someone
whatever.
Will call you out, they'll be like, no, it was this person!
But other than that, like, how did you kind of think about, like, what were you thinking?
Well,
when I say what were you thinking, I make you sound crazy, but no, you're not. But like,
I know what you meant.
Like, what kind of influenced you, perhaps it's a better word, of into making a team?
Well, it all started, because I was, like, flying around in GTA originally in solo mode, but...
Oh, no.
Then I thought to try and make my own team, make my own team in online, so... I thought we might as well just try that with the white arrows and see how things went with that.
Yes.
I mean, it was...
Sorry about that.
I'm doing it.
So, carrying on, please.
Well, ever since I was flying around in GTA and Sedimo, I thought just to try out make my own team. And then, since then, I mean, it has been successful.
Yeah.
Most times.
So.
And then when it came to after doing a few months of doing the white arrows, and then I think I thought do my own solo display team.
Yeah, because.
But then,
I came along in
like 2018.
Early 2018, yeah. And remember doing the little two ship sorties
with the lasers.
With the lasers. Yeah.
May I butt in real quick?
Yes, sure, Sully.
Whenever you were in Hold on, what display team was this when you came about?
It was the White Arrows before we started forming Vipers. Well, okay, about the White Arrows.
Did you guys used to use like Breastros at one point?
No, I didn't think we did.
I can't remember.
Okay.
I think it was lasers. Remember, lasers we used. Yeah. It was just lasers we used.
Yeah, before the Smuggler's Run DLC came out, I remember Soda. I was in a Milsim at the time, Atlas, with my friend Splay the Slayer, and I met Soda in there, and then we kind of grew apart, and then I think it was last year, or over the summer.
Yeah. I think I vaguely remember, but it was a long time ago. My memory is shit.
I know, probably 2 years ago, isn't it?
Yep. So, what has been some of the highlights of since going solo?
Well, I think what all started off was actually when I finally bought my own laser. To actually put it in the colours of Ghost Tiger, and it's just like,
nah,
you know, since then, it's the jet's been quite popular late since then. My team.
Yeah.
Can I just put in quickly?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
No. This is obviously one of the biggest controversies of GTA, if you think about it. In your opinion, when you look at the laser, what do you see? And it's a mix of multiple different aircraft, but what do you see?
I mean,
this
is quite a good question to be talking about on the podcast. This is a good controversy question. I mean, that's, in my opinion, I think that, like, the front is an F-16.
As well as the wings,
and they're like the tail looks more like, I don't know, maybe an F-35 slash
I was thinking F-18.
F-18 by mass.
Quick question. Yeah. What's everyone's favorite jet in the, like, no, I mean, plane in the game?
For what role?
In the game? Anything.
In general.
The
in
plane.
General.
Anything. Just like any plane.
I like the laser and Molotov. The Russian MiG.
The MiG 15.
Mm. I mean, to be honest, I think the Molotov's got more like a MiG 15 slash MiG 17.
Yeah, I'm thinking
in my opinion.
Yeah.
Because the back of it's a MiG 17 and then the MiG 15 front, I reckon.
Not gonna lie, if I was to tell you two of my most favorite aircraft in the world.
Its fuselage is more like the MiG 15, it's shorter.
Yeah.
Yeah. But
I know. The Miljet and Nimbus.
What I hate is when people say, oh, it's a combination of the MiG 17 and MiG 19. It isn't. The MiG 19 was
twin engine. Is there
even
a MiG 19?
Yeah, it's twin engine. It came out right before the MiG 21.
We're going to get someone chase you off on that one, Sully.
we'll
verify that.
Yeah, the MiG 21 was made quite late.
I mean, talking about MiGs, I did see the MiG 21 lash at React. That was actually quite good.
Was it a Polish?
Really good.
Oh yeah.
It was Romania.
Romanians. The Romanians.
The Romanians
really
use the MiG
21.
Really nice jets, huh?
Yeah, they are really nice.
It had a problem though with rear visibility. It wasn't really that great.
Anyway, right.
Yeah,
where were we, question wise?
To GTA.
It was to do with the controversy of the laser.
Good point. It'd be front and the wings F-16. The back tail fins are like F-18.
Yeah.
Can I agree with that?
Yes.
Bing Bong, I heard you have had some questions that you would like to ask.
Oh yeah, so, does anyone here work at an airport?
My dad used to.
I start fully tomorrow there.
Ooh! So, yeah, So just for the viewers, Ben works at a airport. I'm not going to name what airport.
The area.
Like, if you want to, Ben, would you like to give some insight of, like, behind the scenes, like...
Okay. So basically what I do is a ramp agent, which is basically loading, unloading aircraft's baggage, and as well as doing driving on the on air side. So like the baggage trolleys, the baggage conveyor belt, which goes onto the plane.
Do you like make sure people put them on right, like a manager?
Yeah, I mean, like, I've so far during my training, I've been in the hole pretty much the entire time. I've done a bit more stuff like during last week. I mean, I've done a bit more than expected, like training-wise, because we did the GPU, which is ground power unit, after when the engine's been shut off on the ground.
Yeah.
As well as doing chocks, cones, then I even connected the pushback tug arm, which connects to the plane to the aircraft tug.
All right.
And also, I've actually sat in the I've actually been in the passenger seat of the pushback tug when it was pushing back an aircraft, which is quite an enjoyable experience.
Yeah. So what's been your kind of like favorite role out of all, like, what one do you prefer, like, and what have you learned from, like, what kind of new things about aviation have you learned about it?
Basically, I mean, of course, I like all of the moments so far. I don't have a favorite, to be fair. I mean, I'm just enjoying all at once. And what was the other question as well?
As well as that, like, kind of like, what new stuff have you learned about aviation?
Pretty much how to. So far, I've actually learned how to actually connect the tow arm from the undercarriage and the tug. I mean, like, cause, I mean, I've never learned how to do that until recently.
it must be kind of stressful keeping aircraft moving.
I know.
You've got like a schedule. Everyone's working as a team to kind of get the job done.
I really could not be asked to do it. I'll just shout at everyone.
Like, do you kind of like? Because don't the pilots sometimes have to do like a pre-flight walk around? So like, do you get? To, like...
Yeah. One of the captains walk around the aircraft as well. But after loading everything up, then like one of us ramp people do the final checks around the aircraft.
Yeah.
I've not done that yet, but I mean I have done the wing walking, which is pretty much when the aircraft pushes back.
Not where they get you to like strapped
no, not,
on top
not,
of the plane
not
doing
on the wing. Not on the
doing,
wing.
Doing gymnastics or whatever.
No, not quite.
I can do some yoga on the side of the wing, you know.
Coming soon to an air show near you.
No, not quite that, but I mean, it's like, pretty much when the aircraft pushes back, you're stopping traffic from going driving behind the aircraft.
Yeah.
And then obviously, depending on where you are, you're gonna have to help the tug back and then just like to a certain point and then get the stopping so they can move the aircraft forwards towards the unhitching point of the tug. I mean, it's so far it's really interesting. I mean, Friday I did my first solo wing walking, doing it myself.
Yeah,
it's quite easy.
Well, I've kind of wondered, and it's probably a stupid question, but is there a separate kind of, like, team for when, like, they send the aircraft out, and then when an aircraft returns, do they have different teams of people?
So, like, well, I mean, like, basically how it works is we like the teams that you are at the start. We go with them from aircraft to aircraft, the ones that we're meant to be doing. Yeah, so it's pretty much just like we stay with the same team as when the next lot of aircrafts arrive.
So heavy, do you only, for example, do, for examples, the send off and then people do like the bringing back in?
Or is it? Well, no, we do like... both. We do both.
Okay, fair enough. Fair enough, because I guess then it means that there's less kind of workers, so they pay less people, I guess.
Yeah.
It's not even that. Think about it like this. So that, I mean, if it is a really busy airport, once that gate is empty, once another aircraft has came in, that might already be booked in for that gate after that aircraft has departed.
I guess. Got to keep it all moving.
Yeah. Well, I've got a question for you as well, Ben, when it comes to things like this. What would have to be the best aircraft that you've seen so far while doing this job?
I did one of the newest A321 Neos from EasyJet, which was in service from January 2020, and it's one of the brand new A321 Neos. It was
calling me,
Reg's Mike Hotel MH at the end.
Fair enough.
I load and unloaded the luggage on that.
Fair enough.
To be honest, the holds are massive inside. I mean, it's like I just didn't expect it to be that big from inside the hold. I was like, geez.
And you know how everyone worries about their luggage getting damaged?
Yeah.
Have you seen anyone throw any of the stuff?
No.
And does the airport take it strictly?
Yeah, they do. I mean, like, it's how they do it there.
Fair enough. That's good to hear.
So I mean, if you ever want to fly to Bristol, I mean, like, your luggage will be fine. I mean, like, especially if it's with EasyJet, cause then you probably end up seeing me unloading your aircraft.
Yeah, I didn't think we were gonna mention the name of the airport.
I did own it.
You did.
Sorry. Good giveaway. Oh well.
Would you like to keep that in or?
Yeah, sod it. Okay. I don't care. Anyway, back to GTA questions.
Yeah. As yesterday, the 22nd of February 2020, you did a farewell kind of flypast thing.
Yes.
For your Ghost Tiger demo team.
Yep.
So, what plans do you have, like, after you're done with the Ghost Tiger demo team?
Well, I'm not done with the team. I mean, I'm just having a year break.
It's like a gap year.
Yeah, exactly.
So, for example, what would happen if say GTA 6
Soda wants to take over that team now.
I will bring Ghost Tiger GTA 6 as well.
Mm-hmm.
Because obviously most of you would like to see that.
I have an interesting topic we could speak about.
Well, that depends on what GTA 6 takes Flight place Sim 2020. In, or where it takes place.
Oh, good question.
Oh, yes.
If we could paint our own aircrafts in GTA, no, Flight Sim, sorry. Like with an F-16, I'll probably put F-16 colours in the Ghost Tiger one.
It really like the depends black and if military aircraft are in the game.
By the way, Flight Sim 2020 on Xbox, Big Bug Airlines will be on there. Make sure you book your flights.
Yeah.
and the Deluxe.
Bing Bong Airlines for GTA 6. Hell yeah, we need to bring that back for GTA 6.
I was looking earlier. The whole every single airport in the world is supposedly going to be in Flight Sim 2020.
That means long Bing Bong Airlines flights.
And
can we do it at KCI?
Never heard of it.
Kansas City.
Right, yeah.
Give me a second, I'll be back in a minute.
So basically what they've done is some of the airports, like the most recognizable ones, for example, like London Gatwick, Heathrow,
Manchester,
JFK, probably Manchester as well. Like south of like
Manchester.
South, like really famous ones, and well known. So for example, like Dubai, all that stuff. They basically, most of them, were built like from the ground up, in the simulator. Whereas other airports, basically it's like automated because obviously Microsoft owned Bing, so they can basically they've got satellite stuff of the Earth already, so they don't really need.
I really hope they do have Bristol Airport in that, because then if say they had military jets and I painted my S16 in the Ghost Tiger colors, I'll be basing it at Bristol.
Fair enough.
Because then I could just do some recce over Western, on the, if they actually have like if they make it like proper 3D kind of style, that'd be kind of cool if they did it 3D kind of like
famous graphic. Kind of beach holiday
yes.
setting.
Yes,
which
as
is
that,
what
as
the
that,
UK
that and
the,
as well
for.
As that. I mean, anyway, that's my local, that's my local
bing
town.
We do a sloop.
I don't know.
But anyway, talking of Ghost Tiger, I mean, there are some, when we return, there will be some other interesting stuff happening as well.
So, you're going to be doing anything whilst you're on your hiatus in GTA, or are
you
taking
a complete I might try and work out with the LS Cobras, because I mean, I did say I was going to try and get that sorted out.
Right.
Well, first of all, I need to get a Molotov before I even start any of that.
Okay. So, for example, say they released a new aircraft. Would you try using that, for example?
I'll see how it works, but at the moment, I'm trying to aim to use a Molotov.
Fair enough.
Because hopefully we can try and do a collab at some point with the Vipers and Cobras. LS Vipers and Cobras.
Mm-hmm. We can take a look at that when
the, do that something for the
situation
future.
Arises. Yeah.
Yes. Because actually, the thing is, with that team, I'm gonna I'm gonna try something which has never been properly done before. It's like a whole. It's just a most of the displays pretty much all formations. So like an actual formation team, so like loads of formation shapes in the display.
So no sync.
Try and get some good ones. The ones that no one's ever done before.
I'm back.
That's interesting because we have a couple fairly old Red Arrows formations in our routine this year. I'm not going to say any until.
Damn it.
Until you guys see on the social media stuff.
But then the thing is, like, with the LS Cobras, one sneak peek thing I will be leaking at the moment.
Right.
Pretty much, the entrance will be a wall formation, just to kick off with straight away. That's what
Fair
I'm going to say.
Good
oh,
that's gonna be good.
Quick question.
That's good.
Have I
that's
missed anything while I was gone?
Well, I'm talking about the LS Cobras, the team that I'm going to be making.
What, on Flight Sim or GTA?
GTA 5.
However, if the opportunity arises for Flight Sim, would you consider that?
LS Cobras and...
I'm saying it right now, I'm 100% joining a display team on Flight Sim. And a whole bunch
that
of
would be
kind of
cool, yeah.
Do you know, if the smoke lasted for a longer time?
They should do that with the next update in GTA. Like if they do a more of like a plane,
at least make it last for like 45 seconds or at least a minute. Like the smoke trailing behind.
What I was thinking, if they do another plane aircraft update on GTA 5, they should actually do that. Like
yeah,
make it last
when...
in the sky.
Everyone post on Instagram and, at Rockstar Games.
Yeah, that didn't work last time.
You know
Anyone
what I
want to
see, Soda? I want to see an ultralight display team.
Yes. Ooh. Yes. I said that the other day, Sonny.
Took my idea.
You did?
However.
No, I said I said it when.
All right, guys, back on the subject. Run DLC on. Can I trying to say something there?
Sully.
Yeah.
Remember what we talked about a few days ago. No spoilers, but we'll think about it.
Oh yeah.
Whatever we spoke about.
Message me it. Come on, can't keep it away from me.
Jack, your memory is terrible.
I'll get anything away from you.
Tomorrow's meeting, I'll mention it.
What?
Tomorrow's meeting, 7 o'clock, I'll mention it.
Did we speak about it?
We did. Tomorrow's meeting, 7 o'clock.
What was it?
I'm not gonna say on the podcast.
Yeah, boy. What was it?
Hold on, I'll be right back.
Message me it.
Josh, right, Snapchat me. I don't know where my phone is, but it's somewhere. Oh, it's in my pocket.
I'll Snapchat it at you in a minute.
But
have a minute.
Yeah, for this section, does anyone have any, like, final kind of questions or anything?
Seven.
I had one, but I forgot it. I'll think about it, but, give me just, 30 seconds.
Anything relating with, Ghost Tiger, I mean, like, for the future or something, or...?
Yeah, I do.
Okay.
Is there anyone else flying? Or just you.
As far as we know, is Ghost Tiger is just gonna stay solo.
Okay. Are you gonna do a collab with anyone?
Collabing wise, I would like to do some more with the Vipers. Cause I mean, obviously, they've been with Ghost Tiger since the start. Of when I actually changed the name to Ghost Tiger.
Yeah.
I mean, because it would be quite fun to do some more collabs with Vipers.
Yeah, we can, as I said earlier, if the possibility arises and we have like some time to, then I'm down.
Yep.
Me too.
But otherwise, if no one has any more questions, I am absolutely tired, so... if you want to say anything, Ben, take it away, mate.
Back in a minute.
Basically, I mean, even though it's a gap, a year off, I mean... I am deciding whether to bring it back next year. Not 2022.
So that would be 2 years.
If
it was 2022, wouldn't it?
No. I said I'm thinking of moving it to 2021, the return.
Yeah, which is a gap year. I'm so confused. I'm so tired.
So yeah, I mean, like, Ghost Tiger could potentially make a return on the... on the 20th of February, 2021.
So, we'll look forward to seeing that then.
Yeah.
I think training for that probably won't start until October, November...
Yeah.
...this year.
Kind of depends how your schedule goes. I'm personally thinking of doing another funder over Chumash. If the opportunity arises, do you reckon you would make a kind of appearance, just a one-off appearance?
This year?
Yeah, say if we did another fund over Chumash.
Well, I'll see how my work schedule is, but then I'll let you know. We'll transfer. But just put the thing with Big Thunder, just call it a special act, because I mean, it's nice that we don't give people away. That Ghost Tiger's back.
So you've confirmed that you will be displaying for Big Thunder. You've heard it here first, folk.
it'd be a one-off back, but I mean, that's...
Well, we'll have to wait and see if Thunder over Chumash does happen.
You mean Big Thunder, not
Thunder over Tumor.
Do you not remember last year
when
we did
Thunder
over Tumor?
I mean, it did fuck up at some points, but I mean, it's like...
That was primarily due to a certain group of people, which...
of individuals.
Yeah.
It wasn't.
But I mean,
really?
I mean, they might not Snapchat you. if you do end up doing another Thunder over Tumash, I think that'd be another one-off show as well.
Uh-huh. All right. So, it's been quite a fair amount of stuff being spoke about in this podcast.
I know. I mean, just like.
So, I think we're gonna wrap it up here,
outro. So, who wants to do the outro then?
Thank you very much for listening.
Go on, man.
We're gonna let Demar take it away with the outro.
But thank you, viewers, all very much for watching this podcast with our special guest, Ghost Tiger Team Demo, or Ben. He works at a very nice airport. If you ever want to see more podcasts, just make sure you come over to Boris Johnson's, LS Fire channel. Weird Vipers very much do appreciate you all, and we will see you next week.
And just in the comment section, if you think I sound like Boris Johnson, please let me know.
You do! You do!
You do!
You do!
Boris England!